Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's topic is the earthquake swarm by the island Eldey, which is a small island of the Reykjanes Peninsula, around 15 kilometers out, and it has been shaking quite a lot. Chapter that started in 2021 started actually, so this is nothing new. But the episode today is however quite strong. And the largest earthquake so far was magnitude 5.1, and it could be felt all over West Iceland and South Iceland and Reykjavík, of course. And this is taking place on a volcano that has erupted around 10 times during historic time, and it is currently on code yellow as for aviation, but it's no need to panic or cancel your trip to Iceland, because this is not a surprise. This is in fact just a continuation of a process that began with the 2021 eruption. And some of my viewers might remember me asking questions like, is there a connection? And there are even scientists out there that claim that it is the magma chamber under the offshore central volcano that has been feeding the magma chamber by Svartsengi all the time. But that's another story. And I am not the scientist here, but I am talking about what I notice. And the first announcement from the Met Office today described those earthquakes as tension changes. And to be honest, that was not doing much for me, because when earthquakes stop to involve tension changes, that is when I would be worried. So later in the afternoon, another news agency called them and got another expert on the line. And that expert mentioned the tectonics, and I think it's a bit better answer, although it's not helping me a lot with this video, but I am sure that experts like Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson will have something to say about this, perhaps after a weekend, because he has been predicting offshore eruption for some time, but it's of course a process that could take a long time to unfold. So it's way too early to jump to any conclusions, and I look forward to hear from our professors and volcanologists in the next days. That's where I usually get my best bits of information for my videos. But what we know now for sure is that many of the earthquakes are well above magnitude 3, so it's a huge amount of energy being released there right now, or way more than we usually see. So I am of course curious to see if this increased seismic activity will affect the Reykjanes Peninsula, but I haven't seen that yet, and it isn't always the case. So this event could easily just be isolated to offshore activity. But this week has been lively here in Iceland, although we had no large earthquakes, but obviously lots of tension when we look at the seismometers. And we actually had a new unusual earthquake location in West Iceland this weekend. And the seismic swarm in the north that I covered recently, it hasn't faded out. So when I've been looking at the seismometers in the last days, it has occurred to me that we might see something snap somewhere. And that is what has happened. But as for the island, Eldey, it's one of the locations I've talked about numerous times, because it is a place of geological significance. It's on the Reykjanes Ridge, 15 kilometers from the shore, where the ridge rises up from the seafloor to become Iceland. And the island is very young. It came to being during the so-called Reykjanes eruptions, or Reykjanes fires, between 1210 and 1240. And the main eruption was in 1226. That one started offshore and migrated onshore, and left us with many interesting formations. And the ash layer from that event is clearly visible in many places in soil profiles. And we lost a lot of livestock back then, so it was nasty. But the problem now is not the livestock, it is the nearby international airport and the jet engines. And the island itself, Eldey, it is just a part of a broader chain of submarine volcanoes that includes Geirfuglasker, and there are numerous tales of fishermen reporting eruptions between the island and the mainland. They knew that something was wrong when the fish started to come fully cooked. And although we cannot see the ridge, the time-lapse can do it in a way, because it affects the currents, making this area very dangerous for fishermen and even large vessels. So many islands have emerged here during the centuries and disappeared again, but not Eldey. It's composed primarily of basalt and rises about 77 meters above the sea level. And the island could easily end up on the seafloor, like the nearby and now sunken island Eldeyjarboði. And volcanic activity has impacted history here in different ways. Like the Great Auk, it had to flee from its home on a nearby island to Eldey when hunters found the last confirmed pair and ate it with potatoes. And that left such a wound in the national soul that we made this monument for the Great Auk on the shore. And we have done our best to protect the huge gannet colony that now rules Eldey. So the island is now highly restricted as for access, and close-up footage is hard to find. But there is a webcam out there in case something takes place there. So I'm leaving links to it, but it is, however, a bird camera with some limitations, and it's not broadcasting all the time. But as for the statistics, this event likely fades out. You know the cliché about that, as for the statistics. But since this seismic swarm is stronger than usual, and after all that's been going on, it would not surprise me if this would be the beginning of something else. And this something else could be a volcanic tectonic chapter or more problems than I can cover in a short update like this. So I'm going to stay optimistic, although I will be looking at the seismometers in the next days. And the summer is coming, it will be busy, and it started well this year. We got the hottest week in May ever, which was very helpful for the vegetation and the highland roads that I hope to see opened soon. But I decided after lots of stress and driving around waiting for the April 1st eruption to use May for tourist content. And I finished to sort out my entire video collection as well. It was a big task, so it was a bad month for YouTube business, but a good month for groundwork. And the new gadget that I mentioned recently, this is another teaser, but I can tell you now that I'm upgrading the drone in the next days. But first I had to finish some formalities. I had other equipment to sell that I can be without, and that went fine. So I'm just waiting for a phone call now. And the plan is to drive to the capital, pick it up, and do some filming on the way back so I can show you something more interesting than just unboxing. And I can tell you right away that this is a game changer for the channel. And me as well, like I will explain later. But as for the island Eldey and the earthquakes, if this is developing fast into something, I will of course make a note of that in the video description until I will be online again. And I'm of course linking to local news and the seismometers, because it's still lots of action there. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.